the whole story behind a remarkable object, the chandelier. An object that has been left out in the cold for decades, but is now making a dazzling comeback.
The great thing about a chandelier is the way it elevates the light, since in the olden days people burnt tallow or candles, if they could afford them, which they held in their hands. But some rooms were too big to be illuminated by low candlelight, so the logical step was to raise the light so that it would light up the whole room. The future of the chandelier was doomed when in modern times the ceilings were lowered. Now standard ceilings are 2.5 to 2.7 meters, so obviously for a lot of people having a chandelier is out of the question because they'd keep bumping into it. Nevertheless, today there is a renewed interest in decorative art and ornamental objects, which is exactly what a chandelier brings to a room. There's the archetypal chandelier, which goes back many centuries because it's the one that was made to hold real burning candles and to prevent the wax from dripping. So there are the candle rings and the cups to collect the melted wax. Even today, that remains the classic chandelier.
Ceilings haven't got higher again, and yet everyone now wants a chandelier. But the choice is now a bit more complicated because the classic model has been revisited again and again. Here are a few examples for you to admire without having to crane your neck. Baccarat offers a particularly sparkling spectacle.
What you should know is that in 1824, our establishment only produced pendants which were assembled as desired by the customer. And it was only in 1850 that we first began to make actual chandeliers.
Okay, most of us would have to think twice before buying one of these models. But we have to admit that they're a knockout.
This is a chandelier designed by Philippe Starck that is called the Black Chandelier, and it's made of black crystal.
The game is light works. How do you show those teasing lips?
This is a corridor full of chandeliers which holds the mille nuits collection created by Mathias, which are in a very romantic style. And this rippled glass look that could be described as slightly Venetian. This is a collection called Plume, which is quite revolutionary and interesting, because with this chandelier, you practically make it yourself. You buy the structure, and then you can choose from pendants in 8 different colors.
At Vault and What, it is the sheer number of different styles and the creativity of the designers that takes your breath away.
Pedro Jallo is the designer behind this chandelier. In fact, it won a competition launched by the Spanish supplier Metal Arte. So it is made of glass blown in Italy, but is marketed by the Spanish. It's a new lighting object. We could describe it as a compromise between traditional and modern. This one here has been around for about 15 years now. It's by Ingo Morer, who is a creator who is about 75 years old now, and who was, for a bit of trivia, a friend of Andy Warhol, which explains his style, which is very original and wacky. So the concept is very simple. You can either leave it as it is, because there are messages of peace and love in different languages, or it is sold with blank paper that you can decorate yourself. In fact, this is the smaller model, because 10 years ago, it came in huge dimensions of about 4 meters wide, so it was only really made for people with a very high staircase or a room with an exceptionally high ceiling. This model is much more accessible in terms of size and cost. This is a very popular chandelier because pendants are making a big comeback these days. There's a traditional modern compromise. Here the ceiling is 3 meters high and you can see how low it hangs. So you really need space, otherwise you'll be dining with it. In objects and lighting, black is back, so we have a lot of black objects and a lot of black lamps, and this is one of them. It also comes in red. This one is a 6-arm chandelier, but it also exists in a 12-arm version.
This
This is a chandelier that was designed and created by Mathieu Chandelier, who is an independent French artist, which is very rare, because we mostly work with Italians. And so here he has sheathed the structure in fabric.
I think by now, you are completely enlightened on the subject. All you have to do now is to find the space to hang these works of art in your flat. Good luck.